Hey, I'm Chris. This is MMA for You. I'm going to be doing my predictions for UFC Fight Night 86, Rothwell versus Dos Santos, which happens on April 10th. But before I get into that, I would like to plug my own author's website at www.chrismuldoon.com. I am an aspiring author specializing in the fantasy genre, and you can support my journey of being an author by buying my first novel, a fantasy adventure called The Mustard Prince in the Convent Kingdom, for $8.95 at www.chrismuldoon.com. Also on the website, check out free short stories. There's a new one called The Locket that's out. You can buy some other stories for sale. Check out my blogs, which are updated weekly. And check out the Writer's Talk web series, which is just me talking everything about writing. Okay, on to this card. Surprisingly, a lot of heavyweights on this card. Yeah, Dos Santos Rothwell, Derrick Lewis versus Gonzaga, Francis Ngannou versus Bojan Mahajlovic. I might not be able to pronounce some of these names. I assure you, though, I watched at least one fight of each of these fighters. at least, you know. Just get an idea of what they bring to the table. And Timothy Johnson versus Marcin Tybura. I'm not too sure if Jared Cannonier versus Cyril Askers at heavyweight. It's both small for heavyweight. I wonder if they, or if that's a light heavyweight bout. I think that's a heavyweight bout. There's some like decent prospects on here. Francis Ngannou is actually a good heavyweight prospect. And so is Marcin Tybura. He's really made a name for himself on like the European scene. Did he fight for M1? Shoot. Eastern European scene. Timothy Johnson's actually still a prospect too, at 11 fights, 30 years old. He's actually greatly impressed me. And so you know, Derrick Lewis, he's 31, but like, and has 19 fights, so I don't know if you can call him a prospect anymore. But he's always fun to watch. Return of Maryna, Moroz. She's fighting a strawweight prospect, and Cristina Stanciu. I can't pronounce the last name. Stanciu. I'll say that. Mairbek, Taisumov, real fun action fighter. Some of these other guys, you know, I've seen videos of some of these guys, and I'm just like, some guys have a good stand-up, but it's not great, or like, you know, there's nothing too special about some guys. And Bojan Velickovic, he's good. He fought an RFA. He's actually pretty solid. He's fighting actually a pretty decent prospect, and Alessio did Chirico. So yeah, let's just get right to it. So, Ben Rothwell fights Junior Cigano Dos Santos in the main event. Okay, Junior Dos Santos, 17-4 record, 12 wins by KO TKO, 2 wins by sub. He also has 2 losses by KO TKO, 32 years old. He's 6'4", training out of ATT. He is trading losses on wins these days, most recently losing to Alistair Overeem. He is a former UFC heavyweight champion. At his best, he has good boxing with real heavy hands, strong takedown defense. However, I think it needs to get to be said, he has a hard time pulling the trigger these days. His chin is deteriorating. I mean, the shots that he used to be able to take, he can't take anymore. And honestly, he looks like a guy on the decline. I think his wars against Cain Velasquez, the fight 2 and 3, and that fight against Stipe. And actually, he had a war with Mark Hunt, too. I think they've really deteriorated in him. I think he looks slower, looks less inclined to pull the trigger. His chin's not as good. Yeah. But Ben Rothwell, 36-9 record, 20 wins by KO TKO, 13 wins by sub. Has his 4 losses by KO TKO and 2 losses by sub. 34 years old, he's 6'4 on a 4-fight win streak, most recently choking out Josh Barnett and giving Josh Barnett his first submission loss. The thing with Ben Rothwell is he is stupid tough, stupid resilient. I mean, it's just, he's really resilient, very game. You know, he's a guy that's always in the fight. Doesn't matter if it's round one, round three. Heck, it'll probably be round five, and he'll still be in the fight. Yeah, despite having four losses by KO or TKO, he does have a really strong chin. That really helps him. He's always pushing forward. He's unorthodox, too. He'll switch stances. He has his weird hand trap fighting thing going on. He's not super technical, though. You know, it's like he has a really ugly style fighting. It's not the most technical, but it's awkward and effective. Real heavy-handed guy, though. You know, you have to respect his power. And he does not always have to respect yours. That's a Ben Rothwell trademark. Takedown defense is actually pretty solid. And he's showing a really good front choke series these days. Showed it against Matt Mitrione and most recently against Josh Barnett. No more doubting Ben Rothwell. No more will I do that. You know, if this were a couple years ago when Sagano was at his front, you know, at his peak, you know, looking like the number one or number two guy, I'd easily pick Dos Santos. These days, I think Dos Santos is too much on the decline. Ben Rothwell is just going up and up. I think Ben Rothwell can hurt Dos Santos too. Pretty bad. So, with that said, I'm going to go Ben Rothwell by KO or TKO. I think Ben Rothwell can catch him. I would not be surprised if Ben Rothwell walks through a lot of what Dos Santos can do. Dos Santos used to really throw the jab, and actually Ben Rothwell has shown pretty susceptible to the jab. Josh Barnett was pretty successful with it. Others have been successful with it. The problem with Dos Santos is he just does not want to pull the trigger. These days, you saw in the Overeem fight, and you just kind of see it as of late. You know, a guy that's gets wobbled a little more, dropped. And Ben Rothwell looks like he is, like, really hitting his stride right now. Like I said, yeah, wouldn't it surprise me if Dos Santos is a little gun shy here. But Rothwell always pushing forward, eventually catch him for the KO or TKO victory. Next fight after that, Gabriel Napao Gonzaga fights Derrick the Black Beast Lewis. Okay, Derrick Lewis, 14-4 record with 1-0 contest. He has 13 wins by KO or TKO and 1 win by sub. He also has 2 losses by KO or TKO. 31 years old, 6-3 on a 2-fight win streak. He's taking this fight on short notice. His boxing is actually pretty solid. Super heavy-handed. This guy is really strong. His ground and pound is like fight ending. I mean, this guy has stupid power in his strikes. But he is weak off his back. Improving, though. Actually, he showed some improvement when he TKO'd Grabowski. Just manhandled him to the floor. An unrelenting ground and pound on him. Stood over him. Wailed on him. Did it again. Rinse and repeat until he got the TKO victory. Gave on Gonzaga, 17-10 record, 7 wins by KO or TKO, 9 wins by sub. He also has 8 losses by KO or TKO, 36 years old, he's 6'2". He's only won 1 of his last 4, and most recently beating Konstantin Erokin in a terrible fight. That was one of the worst fights like you can ever watch. You know, it was just a bad heavyweight fight. Gonzaga did what he needed to do to win and avoid Erokin's power. But the thing with Gonzaga, he is a legit Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. Santos actually pretty solid. He's very heavy-handed, heavy feet too. His wrestling actually isn't too bad, both offensively and defensively. His problems are his chin are not very good. He's not particularly quick. And his cardio isn't particularly good. One other thing about Lewis that I forgot to mention, that guy's game, man. I mean, I remember the regional scene when he fought Jared Rorschach and was losing and then knocks him out in like the third round or fourth round. Same against Victor Pesta. I mean, he's just a guy that's always in the fight. So with that said, even though Lewis is taking this fight on short notice, I gotta pick him to win. I can't trust Gonzaga to win fights these days against guys who are really heavy-handed. it's just, you know, he's getting to the point where, like, you touch him hard enough and he wilts, you know? I think Gonzaga can win this for sure. Because he's pretty skilled, well skilled, you know? Stand up and, like, especially into grappling. If he gets this on the floor and he's on top, Lewis is done. So it wouldn't surprise me to see Gonzaga get the submission victory. Wouldn't actually surprise me if he gets a knockout, because Gonzaga is capable of knocking guys out. But I like the improvements that Derrick Lewis has been making. I think he hits stupid hard. And, he's not going to be like Konstantin Arokin, where he's just going to sit back and do a lot of nothing. Which, you know, Gonzaga just did a little more than that, you know? But yeah, like I said, if Gonzaga gets the floor, I would give it to him. Otherwise, I am going to go Derrick Lewis to win this one by KO or TKO. I think that he can touch Gonzaga up, drop him. And if Lewis is on top and starts raining ground and pound, it's done for Gonzaga. I'll go Derrick Lewis by KO or TKO. Next fight after that, Bojan Mihajlovic fights Francis Ngannou. Ngannou, 6-1 record, 3 wins by KO or TKO, 3 wins by sub. 29 years old, he's 6-4 on a 5-fight win streak. Trains out of MMA Factory, which is a really good gym these days. Taylor Laplace and Michael Labute train out there. He's a finisher. The thing with Ngannou is that he's really raw. Like, he's a good athlete. He's big, but he moves pretty well for his size. You know, he's a good athlete for a heavyweight. He looks like a freaking linebacker. He looks like an NFL linebacker, honestly. He's a strong guy, really strong. His kickboxing is solid. He's heavy-handed. His grappling, at the very least, is improving. Bojan Mihajlovic, 10-3 record, 4 wins by KO or TKO, 2 wins by sub. 35 years old, he's going to be the shorter fighter at 5'11 on a 10-fight win streak. It's his first fight in the UFC. And I got to say, Bojan is small for heavyweight. He should probably be fighting at light heavyweight. And honestly, at 5'11 these days, probably even middleweight. His game really is a strike to the clinch. You know, I watched one of his fights. That's kind of what he did. He just kind of struck to the clinch, get his opponent up against the cage, tried to take him down from the clinch and whatnot. He showed some pretty good ground and pound ability, but otherwise, that's all I've seen from his game. With that said, I gotta go for Francis Ngannou to win this one by KO or TKO. He's gonna be the much bigger fighter, probably the better athlete. And he's developing, you know, he's a good prospect for heavyweight. Francis Ngannou, I think he can, you know, get some good strikes in there. Out-athlete Mihajlovic too, you know, like, defend takedowns just with, like, brute power even. Ngannou for KO or TKO. Right off that, Marcin Tybura fights Timothy Johnson. Marcin Tybura, 13-1 record, 5 wins by KO or TKO, 6 wins by sub. He's 30 years old, he's 6'3", and it's his first fight in the UFC. I watched his fight against, I believe it was Stephen Poetz. Yeah, I think it was Stephen Poetz. The name of Tybura's game really is his top control. I mean, he's really good in the clinch. His clinch takedown game is really good. He'll go for the single, but he's not really a power double type guy, but he has really good clinch takedowns, like trips and whatnot. And once he's on top, man, his ground and pound solid. He'll pass to mount. He has some strong Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu skills. He actually has a couple accolades in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. His stand-up, though, isn't that great. It's just average at best. He's definitely a guy that's been making waves in the European, Eastern European scene. He's fighting Timothy Johnson, who has a 9-2 record. 5 wins by KO, TKO, 4 wins by sub. 30 years old. He's 6'3". Also a guy that's good in the clinch, you know. He's a good wrestler, too. Super resilient. Like, a guy that seems to always be in the fight. You saw him in, like, the Jared Rochel fight. He almost won it in the very end of the third round, where he started to tee off on Jared Rochel. His stand-up's actually really improving. His boxing's good. He's pretty heavy-handed. And he is a finisher. Okay, so here's the thing. Here's the thing. I like Marcin Tybura. I think he's very good. I think he can win this fight. But I don't know if he can take Timothy Johnson down. Johnson was able to hold to show good takedown defense against Jared Rochel. Rochel managed to take him down at the end of the first round or something like that with like a double leg, you know. Otherwise, from the clinch, Timothy Johnson's good there. Stand-up wise, I gotta favor Johnson here. And I think he's the better boxer. I think he's a bit tougher, too. I mean, the guy's just tough as nails. And he's big. You know, they're both big guys. But, you know, Timothy Johnson's a big guy. Real tough. Improving strap boxing. And you know, Marcin Tybura, his path to victory, in my opinion, is to get the fight to the ground and be on top. And Johnson being a pretty good wrestler, I think that's going to be very hard to do. It's also Tybura's first fight in the UFC. The other thing is, too, some of these European prospects can be very hit or miss. I just mentioned Konstantin Arokin, who looked great, you know, in the regional scene. And then, you know, he fights Victor Pesta and just gets freaking taken down all day, every day. I think, obviously, Marcin Tybura is better than that. But, I don't know. I think he got one of the tough outs of the division. And I've been doubting Timothy Johnson for far too long now. I'm going to go Timothy Johnson here. I'm sure Tybura is probably the favorite. But, I think stylistically, Timothy Johnson, being the wrestler that he is, having the stand-up that he is, being as tough as he is, it's going to be a pretty tough night for Tybura here. So, yeah, I'm going to go Timothy Johnson. I'll go by decision, just because Tybura's not a guy I know. I mean, he's only lost once, you know? So, I can't really say if Timothy Johnson can finish him. But I think stylistically, from what I can tell, I like what Timothy Johnson has to offer. Stylistic against Tybura. So Timothy Johnson by decision. Next fight after that, Igor Pokrajac fights Jan Blachowicz. Blachowicz, 18-5 record. 5 wins by KO TKO, 7 wins by sub, 33 years old. He's 6-2 on a 2-fight losing streak. Name of his game, I mean, his stand-up, his kickboxing, it's good. It's solid. He had that really nice body kick. Yeah, he has a really nice body kick, especially. Pretty much finished Alir Latifi with that body kick. But he's a really low-volume striker. He's pretty heavy-handed. Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is good, but in the UFC level, it's not that good. You know? Igor Pokrajac. 28-12 record with 1 no contest, 15 wins by KO TKO, 9 wins by sub, has a 6 losses by KO TKO and 2 losses by sub, 37 years old, he's 6 foot on a 3-fight win streak, trains out of ATT, if I'm not, from what I just read. He's returning to the UFC since December 2014, he was losing, he had 3 fights out of the UFC, one like, I want to say they're all like first round arm bars or something like that. Now he's back in the UFC. For Craig's, you know, his stand-up's good. He hits hard. Defensively, he's not that great. His Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is actually solid. When he's on his back, he's not that great, though. Takedown defense, probably needs some work. I remember he was getting taken down over and over by, like, Stephen Bonner, you know? And his chin is a bit questionable, too. So it's actually tough for me to call it because I'm not... I'm really not that high on Jan Blachowicz, but I think he's the better fighter of the two. I think standing, I think Blachowicz can do well. And even for Crash, chin isn't that good either. You know, I mean, 6 of his 12 losses are by KO TKO. You know, he's a guy that gets finished a lot. He's going to be a smaller fighter, too. Jan Blachowicz by KO or TKO to win this one. I think that Kratz's defense overall isn't that great. Offensively, he's a good fighter, though. Hits real hard. Defensively, not that great. So, Jan Blachowicz by KO or TKO. Okay, on to the prelims. I'm not too sure which ones are going to go into Fox or, in Fox Sports 1, and which ones are going to be in the UFC Fight Pass. So I'm just going to list them all. I don't know the bout order yet, so let's start with Maryna, the Iron Woman, Moroz, fights Cristina, Barbie, Stanciu. I need to get her name right, you know, Stanciu. Has a 5-0 undefeated record, 1-1 by TKO, 3 wins by sub. She's only 21 years old. She'll be the smaller fighter, or shorter fighter at 5'4". It's her first fight in the UFC. I saw 2 fights of hers. One thing that was really noticeable about her, she's really aggressive. Aggressive to the point of reckless, though. Seemingly actually hits pretty hard. I saw 1 fight where she dropped this her opponent with a head kick. She's real reckless about everything, though. You know, she just kind of throws a bit recklessly. Same with her grappling, you know, she'll try and take the back, and it's just, she'll leave space and just, like, try and jump on it or something, jump on a position. But it's real reckless about the way she goes about things. Marina Moroz, 6-1 record, 1 win by TKO, 5 wins by sub. She's 24 years old, 5'7". She is a finisher. She has good boxing. On the ground, really, it's not like Ronda Rousey or something either. She has a good arm bar, but that's all she really has, like, honestly. And it's not, like I said, it's not really like Ronda Rousey's or anything, or it's like a crazy good arm bar. And honestly, when she fought Valerie Letourneau, she seemed to not know what to do off her back, really. When she was on the bottom of side mount, she was just kind of, she seemed a bit lost, actually. So it's actually hard for me to call, I'm not going to lie. I would assume, the problem with Marina Moroz is that when she armbarred Joanne Calderwood, she got boosted up in the rankings. And, you know, she's only 24 with 7 fights. She's getting better. You know, when I saw her in the regional scene and I see her now, boxing's a little better, you know. So that, you know, that's good. But the thing is, you know, Valerie Letourneau kind of exposed some weaknesses in her game that I figured they were there. I picked Letourneau to beat her, and she did. Yeah, this one's actually hard for me to call because I like Stanciu's aggression. And as reckless as she is, she's been effective with it so far. And Moroz is still very much unpolished, too. You know, she's not, like, she's probably the more technical. But, you know, on the ground, you know, she can lose position. She jumped to an armbar. You know, she pulled guard for an armbar. That's not smart, you know. Nonetheless, I will go with Marina Moroz to win this one. Actually, it would not surprise me if she catches Stanciu with an armbar. So I got Marina Moroz by submission here. However, I actually like Cristina Stanciu's chances here. I think that seems like very aggressive, decent athlete. None while varied in her attack, but Moroz is fond of UFC, a bit more technical with her boxing, fought some pretty higher level competition. So Maryna Moroz by submission. Next fight that, Zach Cummings fights Nicolas Sharpshooter Dalby. Dalby, 14-0 record with one draw. So he's undefeated, technically. That draw being against Darren Till. Really fun fight, by the way. 4 wins by KO Tico, 3 wins by sub, 31 years old. He's going to be a little shorter by 5'11". Trained out of Rumble Sports. Another fight on the card, Demir Hadzovic trains out of there as well. So it's like Penny Kanzad from Invicta. Dalby has some good stand-up, particularly good kicking game. He uses a lot of kicks. He's real high volume but low power. His wrestling actually isn't that bad, you know, both offensively and defensively. He's a good wrestler. Overall grappling game is pretty solid. Zach Cummings, 18-4 record, 5 wins by KO Tico, 9 wins by sub. Has those 2 losses by submission, 31 years old. He's 6 foot, trains out of Glory MMA and Fitness with the likes of James Krause. He is big for 170. I think this guy was fighting at 205. Like back in MFC, fighting 205, a fight or two. He has some strong Brazilian jiu-jitsu skills himself. His wrestling's good. And his stand-up's improving, as shown in his fight against, didn't he knock out Dominic Steele? Or was it Waters or Steele? One of the Dominics. I think it was Dominic Steele. Knocked him out. Just rushed the guy. Put him out in the first, minute or 2 minutes or so. This one's actually really hard for me to call. Zach Cummings is big, he's tough, and he uses that size, especially in his grappling. Dalby is a good technician, good everywhere, good volume, not a potent finisher. I'm kind of going back and forth with this. I eventually went with Dalby to win this one. I feel he's a little more variety in the striking. I don't like that he's kind of low power. I think Zach Cummings probably has some more power in his strikes. Grappling-wise, Dalby's a good enough grappler. I think he can avoid getting taken down. It's tough to say because Cummings also is just, he's big. You know, he's just big for the weight class. That's really hard to deal with. Dalby did fight Darren Till in his last fight. It was pretty big in the weight class himself. I think the guy's like 6'2", and did pretty well against him. So, I'm going to go Nicolas Dalby by decision, but tough one for me to call. Next fight off that, Demir, the Bosnian Bomber, Hadzovic, fights Mairbek Taisumov. Taisumov, 24-5 record, 13 wins by KO Tico, 9 wins by sub, 27 years old. He is a shorter fighter at 5'9", on a 3-fight win streak, trains out of Tiger Muay Thai. He's a strong kickboxer. He has some really cool, he'll go for like spinning attacks and whatnot. He has really good timing with his strikes, though. Good kicks, good punches, particularly heavy-handed, too. His takedown defense is improving, too. Demir Hadzovic, 10-2 record, 5 wins by KO Tico, 3 wins by sub, 29 years old. Taller fighter at 6 foot, on a 6-fight win streak, trains out of Rumble Sports. So, I watched one fight of his. I liked his kickboxing. He uses a lot of movement, too. He moves pretty well. He's generally not just a stationary target. I thought some of his best strikes are actually knees from the clinch. The fight I saw, he fought Ivan Musardo, I think, is the fight I saw him against, if I'm not mistaken. So, yeah, he showed good kickboxing. His ground and pound when he was on top was good. However, he didn't seem like the best wrestler or anything like that. You know, he seemed all right there, but offensive takedown ability didn't really seem like it was there, and you know, takedown defense. I can't really tell if he has good takedown defense or not. I gotta get Mairbek Taisumov in this one, though. Way more experience, I think, is gonna be the better. Hadzovic's a good kickboxer, whereas I think Taisumov is a great kickboxer. And he's also just fun in the UFC. Yeah, this will be, Hadzovic's first fight in the UFC. Yeah, I'll go Mairbek Taisumov to win this one. Tough to say if he can get a knockout on Hadzovic, but, you know, he is that good with the striking, so I don't know if it's happened yet, if Hadzovic's been knocked out, but maybe this is the fight where it happens. Mairbek Taisumov, KO or TKO. Next fight that, Ian Enty Entwistle fights Alejandro El Diablito Perez. Alejandro Perez, 16-6 record, 7 wins by KO TKO, 5 wins by sub, has the 3 losses by submission. He's a shorter fighter at 5'6". Kind of one of those good everywhere, but not great at any one aspect of MMA tough guys. Stand-up's good. His overall grappling game, solid. His wrestling's actually not too bad. Ian Entwistle, 9-2 record, 1 win by TKO, 7 wins by sub, 29 years old, he's 5'8", and last fought in December of 2014. He is a leg lock specialist. He's a guy that will pull guard. He will do flying guard pulls, like those, and just sell out on a leg lock. It has cost him against the likes of Dan Hooker. It has allowed him to beat, dude whose name absolutely escapes me at this moment. he has some strong Brazilian jiu-jitsu skills. His stand-up's kind of weak, though. So, this is, I mean, really, it comes down to, and this will be every Ian Entwistle fight. Do you think he can get the submission or not? That's all it comes down to. Every Ian Entwistle fight, you just have to ask yourself, okay, can he pull guard, get his leg lock, and get the win or not? I don't know. That's what makes out. Perez is a more well-rounded fighter, but he's not, like, particularly scary at any one aspect of MMA. You know, it's not like you have to really fear stand-up. You really got to fear his wrestling. You got to really fear nothing. He doesn't have to really fear anything. I think he's straight out of the AKA, though, so, or, like, one of the bigger camps. So that might help him against a guy with the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu of Entwistle. But I've been relatively unimpressed with Alejandro Perez. I can go Ian Entwistle by submission. Tough to say. Like I said, Entwistle, it's just, is he going to sub you or not? Really, if he doesn't sub you, he's probably going to lose. That's how his fights go. So I'll go Ian Entwistle by submission. I think he'll be able to find some creative way to get the fight to the ground, sell out on some leg lock or some other submission, and get the submission victory. Next fight, Philippe Pejic fights Damian Webster Stasiak. Webster's his nickname. Stasiak, 8-3 record, 1 win by KO, 5 wins by sub, 26 years old, he's 5'8", last fought in April of 2015. He has a karate background, actually. You can kind of see it standing, but actually, he has a pretty good offensive takedown ability, and his overall Brazilian jiu-jitsu skills are solid. Philippe Pejic, 10-1 record with one draw, 6 wins by KO TKO, 3 wins by sub. He's 5'11". It's his first fight in the UFC. So I saw one fight of his. His kickboxing is actually not too bad. He's a decent grappler, but here's my problem with him when I saw his fight. Totally forgot who the opponent was, the name of his opponent. He seemed far too content off of his back. When he was taken down, he just seemed like he just wanted to play guard and just stay on his back the whole time. This isn't good, especially in the UFC level. A guy like Stasiak, too, he's a guy that will go for offensive takedowns and will try to work his top game. So, yeah, I'll go Damian Stasiak. I think he can get the takedowns on Pejic and work some top control. I'll go Stasiak by decision. Next fight after that, Lucas Monero Martins fights Robert the Hammer Whiteford. Whiteford, 12-3 record, 6 wins by KO TKO, 1 win by sub, 32 years old. He's a shorter fighter at 5'9", trains out of Dinky Ninjas and ATT. The thing with Whiteford is his stand-up is actually pretty good. He's shown to be relatively heavy-handed. His grappling is okay, you know. It's improving, you know. He can go for zone offensive takedowns if need be. Takedown defense is all right, but not great. Off his back, he's nothing special, really. Martins, 15-3 record, 11 wins by KO TKO, 4 wins by sub. That's just 2 losses by KO TKO. 27 years old, he's 6 foot on a 2-fight losing streak. Trains out of Shuto Box and Makaka Gold Team. Name of his game is his Muay Thai. He's particularly heavy-handed. He's actually shown to have some pretty good takedown defense. They have a common opponent in Darren Elkins that they both lost to. Elkins was unable to take Martins down, but he was able to pin him up against a cage and just keep him up, his back against a cage. Whereas Whiteford, when he fought Elkins, I believe he was taken down and just got Elkined. You know, where he just, Elkins just keeps punching you and punching you and punching you. And it suffocates you and keeps doing it. And it's not enough to finish you, but it looks really, really miserable. And Martins' overall grappling is improving too. Like, he will go for, try to take the back and get the rear naked choke, for example. Tough one for me to call. I actually like what I see out of both these guys, both Whiteford and Martins. However, I kind of like Martins' Muay Thai game a little better. I think his takedown defense, too, is pretty solid. Whiteford's a tough guy, but I'll go with Lucas Martins. I'll go by decision, even though it wouldn't surprise me to see like a KO TKO. Tough one to call. I think they're both around kind of the same level. And next one after that, Cyril Silverback Asker fights Jared the Killer Gorilla Cannonier. Okay, Cyril Asker, 7-1 record, 3 wins by KO TKO, 2 wins by sub, 30 years old. He's on a 5-fight win streak. It's his first fight in the UFC. So I saw one fight of his. He showed some pretty good offensive takedown ability. You know, he tries to pin his opponent up against a cage, take him down from there, unload ground and pound, trying to go to mount. It's a real basic game, like a real meat and potatoes game, but it's effective. You know, his boxing looked good. I'd say it's average. You know, it's not great. The opponent I saw him off against, I totally forgot the guy's name, was managing to tag him near close to the third round. He's also not particularly big for the weight class. If they're fighting at heavyweight, I'm not too sure what weight class they're fighting at. But if they're, both these guys aren't particularly big for the weight class. Jared Cannonier, 7-1 record, 3 wins by KO TKO, 3 wins by sub. Most recently lost to Sean Jordan. His boxing is actually pretty solid. He's heavy-handed. His grappling, decent at best. He's more power and athleticism than anything else when it comes to his grappling. You know, it's hard to trust guys coming off of the UFC scene. You know, I mean, Garrett McClellan managed to get a win in the UFC, but otherwise he's not that good. Ron Potts really fizzled out. And I think there's another guy, too. That's out of EFC. I'm not too sure. And like Cyril Asker's fought a good amount in EFC. Cannonier, I think, is also just a better athlete. So I'm going to go Jared Cannonier to be able to touch him up a bit and get the KO or TKO victory. And finally, Alessio de Chirico fights Bojan Serbian Steel of Velickovic. Velickovic, 13-3 record, 3 wins by KO TKO, 8 wins by sub, 27 years old, he's 6'2". I want to say they're having this fight at middleweight, if I'm not mistaken. Velickovic is on a 4-fight win streak, training out of, I believe he trains out of Elevation Fight Team these days. Yeah, it's his first fight in the UFC. His stand-up's good, you know, but he throws a lot of single strikes. Against Ben Smith, he showed some good grappling, you know, won by guillotine. His overall scrambling ability didn't look too bad either. DeChirico, 9-0, undefeated record, 4 wins by KO TKO, 4 wins by sub. 26 years old, he's 6 foot. So his first fight in the UFC. He's very much like Velickovic standing, just good, you know, good stand-up. You know, he throws good kicks, but he throws a lot of single strikes. And his grappling, I'd say it's average, you know, from the video I've seen from him. Tough for me to say who's going to win this one. I'll go with Velickovic just because, one, he's training with a better, higher-level team. Two, he's also fought the higher-level competition. So I'll go Bojan Velickovic by decision. However, I can't really imagine how this fight's going to go. You know, a lot of both these guys are like single strike type guys, decent athletes, you know. I like the lack of a scrambling ability on the ground. It looked pretty decent. But otherwise, I can't really see how the fight's going to go, but yeah, I'll go Velickovic by decision. Okay, to recap, I have Ben Rothwell beating Junior Dos Santos by KO or TKO. Derrick Lewis over Gabriel Gonzaga by KO or TKO. Francis Ngannou over Bojan Mihajlovic by KO or TKO. Timothy Johnson beating Marcin Tybura by decision. And Jan Blachowicz over Igor Pokrajac. I say decision or KO or TKO? I totally forgot. I think it was KO or TKO. On the prelims, Maryna, Moroz versus Cristina Stanciu. I have Moroz winning by sub. Nicolas Dalby fights Zach Cummings. I have Nicolas Dalby by decision. Mairbek Taisumov versus Demir Hadzovic. Mairbek Taisumov by KO or TKO. Ian Entwistle fights Alejandro Perez. I have Ian Entwistle by submission. Damian Stajak fights Philippe Pejic. Damian Stajak winning by decision, right? Yeah, I think so. Lucas Martins fights Robert Whiteford of Lucas Martins by, I think ultimately I picked decision, but wouldn't surprise me if he got a KO or TKO. Cyril Oscar versus Jared Cannonier of Jared Cannonier by KO or TKO. And Alessio de Chirico versus Bojan Velickovic of Bojan Velickovic by decision. So that's it for my predictions for UFC Fight Night 86, Rothwell versus Dos Santos. If you have any comments, just leave them below. And please support my journey of being an author by buying The Mustard Prince in the Condiment Kingdom for $8.95 at www.chrismaldong.com. So that's it for MMA for you. Thank you guys very much.